Hello everyone, this is Akash Suman here. Now we are going to solve the problem based on the degree of freedom. Okay. So for finding out the degree of freedom, first you have to know the formula of degree of freedom, that is 3. L minus 1 minus 2 J minus H. Okay. Where L represents the number of link and J represents the number of joint. Number of joint means number of, if there is a tertiary joint and a quaternary joint, you have to convert it into binary joints. Okay, how can you convert one ternary is equal to two binary and one quaternary is equal to three binary? Okay, so all the joints that you are going to summation, that would be the binary joints. Okay, or you can also say that this is the number of lower pair. J is also known as the number of lower pairs. Lower pair means if there is any surface or line, surface or area of contact, that would be considered as the lower pair. And H represents the number of higher pairs. So we will calculate one by one. Before we calculating this number of links, this would be a little bit tough diagram. Now we will make it easy. Okay. So that is, I'm going to show you how can we make it easy. That is, our link, and that is having shaded portion. Okay, you already know that the shaded portion considered as one link. Okay, this is basically the shaded portion. I'm going to draw you this one. Okay, now this roller connecting this and the this. So I'm going to write it one link, okay, and the next I am going to draw another link that is also having the shaded portion, okay, that is also having the shaded portion, and that is another link that is also having the shaded portion. Okay, now it is going to connected by another link that is also having the shaded portion. Here you can see there is a slider. How can you convert the slider into simple form? See, slider connecting two links. That is one and that is another. Okay, so this slider can be convert into like that. Okay, so that is the another link. And that is final link that I am going to connect. Now the diagram is complete. You just need to calculate the number of link and the number of joints. So first we will calculate the number of link. Okay, so this is one. Okay, because shaded portion consider as one link. That is two and that is three and that is four, that is five, that is six link and that is seven and that is eight. Then the number of links in the mechanisms are 8. And how many number of binary joints? Okay, we will calculate the number of binary joints. So that is one binary joint because it is connecting one link and the third link. That is one binary joint. That is another binary joint. That is another. And that is also the binary joint. This is also binary joint. And this is also binary joint. Be careful when you count the number of joint because the confusion will create for ternary or quaternary joint. Okay, so be careful about when you count the number of joint. This is the binary joint because it is connecting sixth link and the fifth link. Okay, this is not the quaternary joint because the shaded portion considered as one link. This is binary joint and this is binary joint and this is also one binary and this is also binary and all the binary joints have completed. Now we just need to count. So this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So how many binary joints are there? 10. Okay. How many number of higher pair? Is there any point contact or line contact? No, there is no point contact or line contact. Okay. So that would be the 0 higher pair. And you just have to put the values in this equation, you will get the final value. So I'm going to write here that is f is equal to 3 into 8 minus 1 minus 2 multiply 10, and that is 21 minus 20, and that is 1. So the degree of freedom you get is equal to 1. That means the number of motion possible is 1. I hope you will get the solution of this question. I'm going to tell you again the important points. This roller connecting this link at the this link, so I can write it like that. This become one link, and this slider connecting this link and this link, so I can write that like that. Okay, so that would be the conversion of the roller and the slider. You can see here in this diagram, it would be easy to understand. So you just have to calculate then the number of links and the number of joints. First you have to make the diagram easy. If you make the diagram easy, then it would be easy to count the number of links and the binary joints. Okay.